Hello everyone. In this video, I will show you how to create an API dataset and how to populate data into the dataset using Domo's public API. For this, I will be referring to developer.domo.com. So let's get started. To start with, we'll first check how we can authenticate our APIs. And for that, we will come to developer.domo.com and click on Overview, click on Platform OAuth APIs and the API Authentication section. So when you go through this, you will notice that you will need a client ID and a client secret to generate a token which will be used to authenticate our API calls. And how do we get this client ID and secret? So for that, you need to click on Dev Portal Login. You need to enter your subdomain. I am using the community instance, so I'll put Domo community. Click on continue. Click on create a client. Give it a name. I'll just give it a name. I'll name it as sample token. And select the scope of your client ID and secret. Now, for this purpose, we just need data access. So I'll click on data and click on create. You can see the client ID and secret is ready. Now copy the client ID and the secret and store it somewhere in the form of client ID colon secret format. Okay. Great. Now let's move on to Jupyter Notebook, where I will show you how we can type the code. So yeah, I have the code written already. In interest of time, I'm not going to rewrite the code. I'll just copy and paste it over here. So let us import all the required modules first. Then I will copy and paste the authentication function over here. I've called it as auth token. And the same client ID and secret, I stored it in an environment variable and I'm going to use it over here. This is the endpoint which we are going to hit to generate the token. All this information is present on developer.domo.com. So please go through it carefully and you will understand which endpoint to be used when. Okay. So let me run this and let me quickly run this or call this function and see what it returns. So I will call auth underscore token. And this gives me the token which I need to use to authenticate my API calls. I'm quickly going to delete this. Great. Now let us move to the second part, which is to create a data set. Now, when you refer to the documentation, you will realize that to create a data set in Domo, what we need is the dataset schema. Dataset schema will inform Domo what columns you need in your dataset and what should be the columns data types. Okay. So I have a sample schema ready over here. So you can see it is an object which has name, a description, rows will default rows to zero because we are just creating the dataset and not putting any data into it right now. And we have set of columns. And as you can see, the columns object has type, which is the data type, and name. So here I've created a sample schema and the data it is going to contain will be a student's roll number, its name, the marks, and date of birth. And as you can see, the data types are string, decimal for marks, and date time for date of birth. Cool. Now, let us see how we can create a dataset in Domo. Again, for this, I have the code ready. All what I'm going to do is copy and paste the code here. So here is my function. The function accepts file path. The file path is nothing but path to the schema which we have created. In our case, it is DS schema, DS schema file.json. I have placed this JSON file in the same directory where I'm writing this code. So I'll just need to give the file name and not the entire path. Okay, great. So let us call this function. Let's run this function first. I'll call this, so create the code ES, and the path would be simply the name in my case. So it is ES schema underscore file dot JSON. And let me run this. And my data set has been created. So this particular function or this endpoint over here will return an object which will contain the dataset ID and some other details which you see over here. Dataset ID is important because like this is the ID of the dataset newly created, and we are going to use this ID to send data to this newly created dataset. So just copy and store it somewhere. You don't need to bother about this ID that much because you can anyway go to Domo and just check the ID. I'll just show you. You can see sample API upload dataset we just now created. And if I click on this, you can see the dataset ID over here. And I'll copy this and I'll do a control F, and it is the same ID that got generated when we created the dataset. Cool. So we have seen that the dataset has been created now. So we'll move on to the third and final step, which is sending data to Domo. Again, I have the code ready. Let me just copy and paste it over here. Now the send data function accepts a data frame. It accepts the dataset ID and the update method. So let me explain this. What is the data frame I'm referring to over here? So when you are sending data to Domo, as of now, Domo only accepts CSV data, right? So I have already created a sample file which just contains one row of data, and we'll be sending this to Domo. How I've written this code, I'll import the CSV as a data frame. Then I will convert it into an in-memory CSV using string IO and will pass this data as payload to our endpoint. Right? Update method, you can select replace and or you can select append over here basis on what your requirement is. If you want to replace the existing data, select replace. If you want to add to the existing data, select append. Cool. Now let us see the sample data we are going to upload. So I have created this file already, and the data you see over here is roll number as 1. Name as Aditya Jain, that's my name. Marks as 100 and date of birth as this. Cool. Now, let us run this and see how it sends our data to Domo. Okay, this is ready. I need to pass a data frame for which I have to. Okay, so our code is ready. Now let me execute this, and now let me call send data. And before I do this, I will have to create a data frame. So df equals read cd.readcsv, and the name is sample load.csv. Now I'll do df, then I need the dataset ID. So the dataset ID in our case is this. Just copy it, paste it over here, and the update method I'll pass as replace. Okay, so we are ready. Let us run this. As we run this, we get a response 204, which means the call was successful. And when we come over here, we see one row of data added over here successfully. And as you can see, it's the same data that we have in our sample file over here. So guys, it's so simple. You can go to developer.domo.com, go through the documentation and start importing data in Domo using APIs, and you'll get a lot of other information on Domo and its API and its developer features that Domo provides on the same URL, developer.domo.com. So I hope you learned something from this video. Thank you all for being here.